Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. Andrea Twarowski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. Let's talk about perio. So whether you are a dental hygienist or a dental assisting student, perio is always something that you have to constantly study, constantly look at. And if you haven't noticed yet, there's perio case types, there's perio categories. So things can get very, very confusing. But I'm going to make it a little bit easier for you today and hopefully explain it in such a way where even you looking in your textbook and reading your notes from school, this will make a lot more sense because I know how confusing, I know how complicated things can be. So I will be going through your perio case types. Okay, so not the categories, not the different methods, but perio case types. So we're talking the case type 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so let me talk about them first. So I'll go through all of them, and then I'll talk about each of them one by one. So the first one is your gingival case type. The second one is early perio. The third one is moderate perio, and the fourth one is advanced perio. Now, some textbooks call it also severe perio, but the right way to do it, the best way to do it, if you are studying for the board exam, for example, is the last stage is called advanced perio. So depending on the textbooks you look at, depending on if you're from Canada or from the States too, that can change, but they all kind of mean the same thing. So whether you learned advanced perio as your fourth stage or severe perio, it means the same thing. So let's talk about the first one first. So gingival diseases. So you might be confused thinking, how is that part of the perio case types if gingival diseases isn't perio? Well, what they just talk about is just simply not perio. They just talk about the gingival only. So your gingiva, gingival area. So they're not talking about the ligaments around the teeth, which classifies perio. So the first case, I know it sounds confusing, but has nothing to really do with perio. Yes, it is a perio case type, but case type 1 has nothing to do with perio. I think they put it in there because you kind of, I'm not saying that you need to have gingivitis to get perio because that's not really the case, but usually before you get perio, your gingiva is red, it could be sore, it could be unhealthy, it could be bleeding, like things always have to start from somewhere. So I think that that's why they put that in as case type number 1. So gingival disease is case type number 1, and that is just simply talking about your gingiva could be red, it could be bleeding, there could be swelling even, there could be pus, so it's just things are not healthy. So does that make sense so far? Yeah, okay. So case type 2 is early perio. So early perio, and listen up here, is 4 millimeter pockets. So not 5, not 6, not 3, but early perio is a 4 millimeter pocket because as soon as you have perio, you have a 4 millimeter pocket. Even if you only have one tooth, one area with a 4 millimeter pocket and all of the other areas are 3s, 2s, 1s even, you still have perio. And that's case type number 1. Let me just check my notes here. So in the textbook, they say that early perio, there's slight bone loss. But technically, you do not notice any bone loss until you get a millimeter of 5. But they do say slight bone loss because yes, early perio means 4 millimeter pockets, but it could also be a 4.2, a 4.4, a 4. Whatever, right? But as soon as you hit that 5 millimeter pocket, you are automatically into the next stage, moderate perio. So, but to know for the board exam, early perio, you could have slight bone loss. You can't really tell unless you have a look in an x-ray, and in the x-rays, you can't tell until you have at least a 5 millimeter pocket, but that's what it says in the textbook. So a nutshell is the first stage is your gingival diseases. The second stage is early perio. There could be slight bone loss, and early perio is a 4 millimeter pocket. Okay, let's see. So the third case type is moderate perio. I left myself some notes to make sure that I didn't forget anything. So this is where you have the 5 to 6 millimeter pockets. Likely you have bone loss as well. Okay, so likely you do have that. And the tooth could start to become loose also, because if you have a 5 or 6 millimeter pocket, if you think about it, your instrument is going in there pretty far. So it would make sense to have slight bone loss. Okay, so that's the third case type. The fourth and the last one is advanced perio. So think your 7 millimeter pocket and up. And that would be, you would have a lot of bone loss at this point. Your teeth would be quite loose, or your tooth, you know, wherever the advanced perio is, and you would likely see some furcations. So does that make sense to everybody so far? So I tried to explain it in a much easier way. I do hope that helps. Let's do a quick recap. So the case type one is your gingival diseases. Okay, so that involves your gingiva only. So think if the gums are red, bleeding, sore, something like that. Case type two is your early perio. So that starts at 4 millimeter pocket. There could be evidence of bone loss. Case type three would be your moderate perio. So that's your 5 to 6 millimeter pockets. There's likely some bone loss happening, and the teeth or tooth is probably a little bit loose also. The last case type is case type four, and that's known as advanced perio, and that's 7 millimeter pockets or more. There's probably quite a lot of bone loss, probably quite a lot of mobility in that area, and you start to see some furcations. So does that make a little bit more sense? I do hope so. I'm just checking my notes to see if I forgot anything. So I could get into a lot more detail, but I tried to keep it simple for you. If you guys have questions, as always, please let me know.